Okay, so the next talk is by Lupna Penabu.
Yes, it's
okay. Okay, great. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. So thank you for introducing me. Good afternoon. I'm happy today to share with you my work about reduction principle for generalizing bona fide risk bound in multi-class setting. This work is done by myself from IME Engineering School and Professor Pascal Lang from Laval University. Why bona fide? The scientific reason is that our ambition is to generalize the most known risk bounds in multi-class setting by applying the developer reduction principle. But I have to admit that the other reason is that my 15 and 12 years old girl don't see the utility to study Latin, so I want to prove them that they are wrong. The most used approach in multi-class learning is a reduction from multi-class problem into multiple binary classifications. Two families of the composition are generally used, one versus one or one versus all. The weaknesses of reduction approaches have been applied in, appointed in Daniel et al. A few more direct approaches to treat multi-class simultaneously have been studied. This, however, leaves unresolved fundamental issues, such as coordinated allocation of the multi-class, of the classification space among partial classifiers, derivation of a global error confidence level from partial ones, and accounting for the structure of the loss function. Our work takes an opposite stance and attempts to treat multi-class jointly. We believe we have four main challenges. First, consider more realistic multi-class setting by quantifying uncertainty in a principled way. Second, represent the multi-class learning in a compact form. Third, provide optimal risk bound in multi-class learning. And fourth, seek tightest possible such bounds. To quantify the classification errors, generally, we use a 0-1 loss function, which is binary and symmetric by definition. In the multi-class context, it seems natural to assume that this function is not asymmetric, since the consequences of various types of misclassification may vary widely. As for instance, in medical diagnosis, the cost of error of classifying a patient with true class cancer in the class code is more than the cost of error to predict the class unclassified and ask for more examination. Additionally, for kind of the reason, in the computing of classification error, is more interesting and prudent to admit that an example is not classified than to misclassify it. So, in our multi-class setting, we adopt those hypotheses. First, we are in a supervised learning context. Throughout this work, we adopt the packed setting where each example is drawn according to a fixed but unknown probability distribution. The loss function is valued and we accept the rejection option. Our multi-class setting, we have two sets of class. First, the observable class in the training set and the predicted classes with the aided class unclassified. The set of NIID examples and our asymmetrical and valued function, Q. With this loss function, we can define the generalization risk is the expected value according of the loss function according to the known distribution. In order to assess the performance of a classifier H on a random test set, it's necessary to consider all possible error cases. In our example, in this multi-class setting, we can take this example with four predicted classes and three observable classes. And also, we have a valued loss function. We take value 0, 0.4, 0.8, and 1. For example here, we have the classifier can predict the class 2, and when the real class is 1, we have a cost of error is 1. But when the classifier predicts the class 1 and the real class is 2, the cost is different, it's 0.4. Let's NCY the number of examples falling into error case CY, so that sum of all NCY is equal to N, the size of our test set. In the sample case of binary classification, the probability of observing K errors out of an example is binomial distribution. By the IID assumption, the random array N has another familiar distribution. It's a multinomial known with the known probabilities. Well, with this asymmetric loss function, we can have C multiple Y error case, which is hard to manipulate in the formulation of the bond on the real risk. instead of error cases, consider the ordered set of S distinct error costs that may be incurred of the loss function Q. In our example, we have four categories of loss with four value of error cost. There is an aggregation function A mapping the set C multiple Y of error cost cases into the set of error costs, which each key CY is equal to the function value QY. With this aggregation function, we can map all the sets of error cases to the set of error cost. Now consider the random vector K representing the number of examples falling into error category I. We reduce all these error cases to category or loss function. So here we have, instead of 12 error cases, we'll have just four error categories. Moreover, the number of examples in each loss category are distributed into multinomial one. As a consequence, by applying the reduction principle, we have first the complexity of multi-class classification depends on the structure of the loss function. And multi-class classification reduces to B-class classification if only if the loss function is binary. Now we will use the following notation. Instead of number of classes, we will use only the number of loss categories S, the error cost of loss category QY, and the reduced multinomial variate representing the number of examples in each loss category with the multinomial distribution. With this distribution, we can redefine our generalization risk. It's the product scalar between this unknown probability and the vector representing the types of error costs. And the empirical risk will be the mean of number of examples in each category. Here we generalize the definition of Langford of tail bound in the multi-class setting. Prior to any observation, given some confidence level delta, the bound is set a function of this threshold R. The bounds defining the property that whatever the threshold, under a true risk greater than the bound, the probability of observing a non-empirical risk below the threshold does not exceed delta. A minimal bound, one which cannot be tightness, is of course unique. The set of pairs R delta over which the bound exists will depend on the particular probabilistic model considered. Minimal bound cannot be expressed analytically. We will instead seek numerical bounds. Several mathematical programs with different computational advantages can be conceivable. This is a direct representation with FPR is the probability that our empirical risk will be less than threshold R. With the minimal multinomial bound, we have the direct representation, but it will be difficult to compute this bound because the cardinality of K will depend, it's a combination, depending on the number of category of errors and the test set. So, an obvious candidate to approximate the multinomial distribution to use multivariate normal distribution as an approximation to multinomial one. And that as the sample size n increase, the normalized multinomial distribution converges to multivariate normal distribution with identical first two moments. The best bound is a solution of the mathematical program. Here we have a very beautiful objective function. It's linear, but the problem is the first constraint. But we prove that this constraint, that F is pseudoconcave in P. As a consequence, any local optima will be a global optima, and we have just to find the KKT point. And we will use a cogeneralization mechanism as a variant of the general method of center to find the optimum. I guess I didn't have time to give all the algorithm. So the algorithm will try in each iteration to find the optimum, our center, by solving this simple linear program. And each iteration we will have an amelioration of the bound. As a summary, we did the generalization of binary classification to multi-class case with the reduction principle. We develop an alternative to traditional approaches of multi-class classification by using mathematical programming. In our opinion, the analysis of the multi-class setting remains a wide open field with a number of challenging research questions in the risk of generalization. The most disadvantages of test set bound that the data used for testing are not used for training, and we can have several extension to pack-based bond or compression test set bond. So you can join me tomorrow at the workshop of pack-based. I will give an essay to generalize this bond in the case of pack-based. Thank you.